The Little Lexicon of Tattooing. To say man knows all is truly a lie. To say he truly knows nothing, indeed, is not. Do you know anything about tribals, dot work, scratchers, blowouts, or trash style? No? That's okay. I still like to learn new things even after 20 years. When you start tattooing, you just cannot know everything. Even professionals who have been in the business 10 years longer than me cannot do anything with a lot of terms around tattooing. Many are of the opinion that this lack of knowledge disqualifies anyone who wants to or is active in our industry. This is complete nonsense, especially since these terms usually sound complicated because they are not translated. Here, in the Little Lexicon of Tattooing, I have listed the most common terms, chronologically from A to Z, so as not to go beyond the scope of this book. You can also find this lexicon on our homepage under dh-tattoo.de in the menu link glossary. Tramp stamp. Meanwhile frowned upon by many, and also called a hooker stamp, the tramp stamp is located on or above the coccyx. Tramp stamp, so the English designation, found at the beginning of the 90s a true hype. This is due to the time when it was still funky and trashy, and the girly culture was revived, so it became a standardized tattoo for girls, and, unfortunately, also boys. Mostly, a not really meaningful motif, actually always a random tribal, was chosen and tattooed. Many who jumped on the tramp stamp hype train are very unhappy with their choice today. So, it is not surprising that it is the most commonly removed motif worldwide. But new fads like infinity loops, names, and flocks of birds have successfully replaced the tramp stamp. Asia style. Asian motifs such as dragons, tigers, Hanya masks or koi are called Asian style. The Asia style is mostly very colorful and rich in contrast, but it can also be tattooed in black and gray in a very minimalistic way, possibly with some colored highlights. Unlike Asian characters, Asian style tattoos often have a spiritual meaning because of their cultural background. Backpiece tattoo. A backpiece is a tattoo that covers the entire back. With a backpiece tattoo, the motif can be worked out in great detail due to the large area of the back, and the design possibilities allow the tattoo artist a lot of freedom. As a rule, a backpiece is a self-contained motif which extends from the shoulders to the hips. In some cases, the tattoo also includes the buttocks, often seen in Asian backpieces. Despite their size, backpieces can be covered very well with clothing if it is necessary for professional reasons. Anesthetic ointment. Anesthetic ointment is a local anesthetic that is intended to anesthetize the area of skin to be tattooed. For tattoo artists, however, the local anesthetic is controversial, as the anesthetic ointment is actually intended for use on healthy skin. If the skin is then injured during the tattooing, parts of the applied ointment can penetrate the skin or the bloodstream. Although an increased health risk has not yet been proven, most tattoo artists advise against using this ointment. Should you still not want to do it without an anesthetic ointment, you should only use it in consultation with a tattoo artist. But let's be honest, pain is actually part of tattooing and is usually overrated. Biomechanics tattoo. Biomechanics describes a special artistic style in the tattoo scene. Biomechanic tattoos became popular mainly by the Swiss artist H.R. Geiger. He had coined the term biomechanics with his machine organic templates and sculptures. Today, Biomechanics tattoos mostly show motifs of openings of the skin, behind which mechanical elements or machine parts are visible, in addition to the respective muscle apparatus. In this style, the focus is usually on the connection between man and machine. Biotattoo. Biotattoos are tattoos that are supposed to disappear by themselves after a maximum of 5 years. However, this is rather questionable, and according to experts, including dermatologists, impossible. Therefore, one can rather assume that this kind of tattoo fades with time, but does not disappear without a trace. What remains is consequently a blurred and washed-out tattoo. It's better to get a normal tattoo. Otherwise, there are alternative adhesive tattoos for the indecisive ones. Blackwork. Any tattoo that is created entirely from pure black color and also does without shading is called blackwork. Many tribals are inked in black, but there are many more motifs and variations of the blackwork. Bloodlines. Bloodlines are the first outlines, the first contours. They are often used for large and detailed motifs, such as realistic portraits. The tattoo artist can orient himself by the bloodlines, even if the colors of the stencil are faded, wiped, or smeared. There are two ways to draw bloodlines. Either they are only inked into the skin with water or with black color, if it is a larger project with several sessions. However, the black paint is very diluted with water. As soon as the tattoo is finished, the bloodlines are covered by the tattoo and are no longer visible. While the colorless bloodlines disappear again after some time, the bloodlines drawn with black color must be covered during the tattooing. Blowout. Blowout is the name given to an unwanted color gradient that results in unsightly shadows on a tattoo. There are several reasons for the occurrence of such an unwanted color gradient. One cause can be, for example, the procurement of the tissue. The actual main responsibility, however, lies with a tattoo artist. So blowouts occur especially when the tattoo artist does not understand his craft. Especially when the insertion is too deep, tattoo blowouts occur frequently. When tattooing, the needle may enter the dermis at most. If it does not reach this depth, the tattoo will fade significantly within a very short time. This is because the skin layer above the dermis is regularly renewed. If, on the other hand, the needle reaches too deep into the tissue, it may cause ugly scarring as well as blowouts. This is because the color can flow into deeper layers of the skin. As a rule, they become visible within 24 to 48 hours after tattooing. Bodysuit. A bodysuit is a special large area tattoo. It is especially popular because it is completely inconspicuous under clothing, despite its size. Bodysuits can extend over the entire body or end at the wrists, elbows, collar neckline, and thighs or ankles. A bodysuit usually consists of a large motif. Comic style. Colorful tattoos in bright colors of all kinds of fictional characters, such as figures from The Simpsons, would fall under the comic style. But also figures from the Marvel and DC world belong to it. Almost everything can be put on the skin in this style. The comic style dominates with strong outlines and bright colors. Thus, for example, muffins, cupcakes, cherries, unicorns, or ketchup bottles are also popular motifs for the comic style. So, there are no limits to your fantasy. You see, you can't really define the border between comic style and other styles. But one thing is for sure. Comic style can be recognized by shape, color, and often by the motif itself. Cover-up. Cover-ups are often the last rescue from the laser for unpleasant tattoos. Old faded tattoos or badly inked motifs can be covered up. However, not every tattoo has the necessary requirements to be covered. The age and the condition of the original tattoo play a big role. Also, size, motif, and color choice are important criteria. An originally very dark motif with many filled black areas can, of course, not be covered with a light filigree motif. If a cover-up is not possible, it is advisable to undergo laser treatment. If this is successfully completed, the tattoo artist can also cover the lasered area with a cover-up. Dot work. Dot work is a style of tattooing in which dots are used instead of lines. Dot work goes back to the origins of the art of tattooing, where the motifs were still beaten into the skin point by point with the simplest of tools. This technique is also today enjoying increased popularity again. However, modern dot works are usually inked with electric machines. A dot work demands a lot from both the tattoo artist and the tattooed person. A high degree of precision and a lot of patience are basic requirements for the realization of a complete motif in dot work. Fan tattoo. Fan tattoos are like a declaration of love, a sign of unconditional confession and timeless support. This applies to soccer clubs as well as to the brand of your favorite sneakers, your favorite band, or your favorite actor. Fan tattoos have an unmistakable message. Flash. A flash is the common name for a tattoo template. In other words, the finished sketch for the motif to be tattooed. Freehand or freestyle. A freehand or freestyle tattoo is tattooed by the artist freehand, so without sketches, templates, or sketches on the skin. For this, the tattooist needs tact, experience, and above all, artistic talent. Hanya mask. Japanese fables have a large repertoire of different demons, which in turn are both good and evil in nature. Such characters are always well suited for tattoos. One of these demons, which you can find very often as a tattoo, is Hanya. Originally the face of a female, Hanya is a mask from the Japanese no theater. It is said to embody negative qualities like anger, hate, disappointment, jealousy, and revenge. The legends tell of a young, beautiful woman who has madly fallen in love, but this love was not reciprocated. This unrequited love turned her into a demon who, from then on, was mischievous. The Hanya face is characterized by a frightened grimace, consisting of large, prominent eyes, a wide-open mouth, with, mostly, golden fangs and golden horns on the forehead. She often wears wild black hair. Ink. Ink stands symbolically for every form of tattoo. In German, the term inken is also used for tattoo. Alternatively, the term inking is often used for tattooing. Prison tattoo. In fact, there were times when rather shady characters had tattoos. One of the most famous motifs for a prison tattoo is the tear at the corner of the eye. The tear is the symbol that the first 10 years behind bars were spent. Even in prison, tattoos are inked. Usually, in secret, with self-made machines and ballpoint pen ink or cigarette ashes as color. The prison tear at the corner of the eye, or the three or more dots on the hand or eye, are familiar to most of us. The dots stand either for the years served in prison, for the number of crimes committed, or for the unwritten prison law: see nothing, hear nothing, say nothing. La Catrina. La Catrina has its origin in Mexico. It has become a symbol for the Dia de los Muertos, or Day of the Dead. In the classical representation, La Calavera Katrina is a tall lady in European aristocratic dress. On her skeleton head, she wears a hat with a wide brim and feather. She was first designed by José Guadalupe Posada. The artist gave her a function critical of society. Later, the further development became a symbol of the Mexican Revolution, and then an icon of the Day of the Dead. There are hardly any limits to the implementation of La Catrina as a tattoo. The interpretations range from realistic to abstract. Modern La Catrina tattoos are often provided with feminine elements like makeup or long hair. Lettering. Letterings, some love them, others can't get used to them. In any case, letterings or letters are among the trend tattoos. Names are one of the most popular forms of lettering, such as the name of the current big love, the child, parents, grandma, or best friend, but also text passages from songs, quotations, worldly wisdom, or the favorite football club are often used as lettering. Mostly, lettering is tattooed in playful or squiggly fonts, but you also see more and more often lettering in old fonts or in comic or graffiti style. Maori tattoo. Maori are the indigenous people of New Zealand. Their tattoos are part of the foundation on which the current tattoo scene of the Western world is built. The origin of today's tattoos lies with the inhabitants of Polynesia on the Marquesas Islands. European seafarers once brought back the Polynesian tattoos from their travels. Maori tattoos are spiritually very charged and stand for a close connection between man, nature, and the world of gods. Depending on the motif, you could see the Maori's position within a tribal community. But many symbols are also used to protect their wearer. Lizards and geckos, for example, are common Maori motifs. They are messengers of the god Moko, after whom the traditional Maori face tattoo is named. Most Maori tattoos are influenced by nature and the elements. Turtle shells, waves, suns, and spearheads are only a small selection of the classic motifs that are or were firmly linked to the life of the Polynesians. Because every symbol has a different meaning, Maori tattoos can be arranged very individually. Mini tattoo. Mini tattoos are very small tattoos, which are especially popular with people who have few or no tattoos, or who have to hide their tattoos for professional reasons. For the tattoo artist, mini tattoos are a challenge because of the limited space. Because the motif should be designed despite the small size, so that you can still recognize it after years. Especially when working with effects or shadows, the demands on a tattoo artist's skill are high. However, fans of mini tattoos have to accept that not every motif can be done easily and, in the long run, attractively inked as a mini tattoo. Neo-traditionals. Neo-traditionals, or also called New School, are the modern heirs of the traditionals. This means that in terms of style, they are strongly oriented towards the old school style, but there are hardly any limits to the motifs. Here, the traditional elements, or above all the style, is important. So here the motifs are what distinguishes old school from new school, and traditionals from neo-traditionals. While an anchor with strong lines and bold colors is more likely to belong to the traditionals, a matryoshka in the same style is most likely to belong to the neo-traditionals. So, the biggest difference is the motif. Modern motifs and designs are therefore called neo-traditionals or new school. Classical seafaring symbols, for example, belong to the traditionals or old school. Only in their design, the two styles are the same. New school tattoo. New school can be understood as an extension of the old school style, a colorful new addition, so to speak. Although new school is inked in the same style as old school, it is much more colorful. New school tattoo dominate with flowy, gauding lines, also in comic style. New school tattoos are often kitschy motifs or exaggerated shapes with many light effects. Characteristics are the thick, clear outlines and the clean, striking designs. Especially important in new school is the new interpretation of the old motifs, such as the Mexican sugar skull, which is often playfully decorated and filled with many bright and gaudy colors. The message at new school is clearly fun. Old school tattoo. Old school refers to a certain tattoo style in connection with certain tattoo motifs. If you want to get an old school tattoo outside of Germany, you should use the term traditional for safety's sake, because this term is much more common abroad. The classic old school motifs include flaming hearts, daggers, and pistols, steering wheels and ships, crosses, sea monsters, cherries, muffins, and of course, the classic pinups. The motifs often stand for adventure, courage, strength, love, and longing. The realization of the motif is mostly characterized by thick black lines and strong, rich colors. Scab. Scabs can form during the healing process of the new tattoo. This is normal, and you should not try to remove them, because this can not only lead to infections and scarring, but also damage the tattoo permanently. When scraping off, color particles can be removed. To avoid scabs, you can cover the fresh tattoo in the first 4 to 5 days with a cling film. Make sure that you wash the tattoo several times a day with clean water and clean your hands and apply a dexpanthol ointment, for example, bupivacaine, before you put the foil back on. The healing process is supported by the cream, and due to the lower oxygen supply under the foil, scabs are rarely formed. Scratcher. Scratcher means a tattoo artist who is actually not a tattoo artist at all. Scratchers are often tattoo artists who have not learned their craft properly. The consequences of the work of a scratcher are often visually inferior tattoos, scars, and blowouts, caused by the fact that the scratchers are neither familiar with the nature of the skin nor with the handling of a tattoo machine. Apart from the often poor graphic skills, they often tattoo their motif too shallow or too deep into the skin. Tattoos that are too flat can be easily corrected by a good tattoo artist with a cover-up. With too deep tattoos, however, often the best tattoo artist has to throw in the towel. Silver skin. During the healing process of a fresh tattoo, the so-called silver skin develops after a few days. This is a new layer of skin that covers the tattoo. The fresh skin layer has a silvery color shine and protects the tattooed area from infections. The top layer of skin, or the epidermis, normally renews itself every 4 weeks. With freshly tattooed skin, this regeneration process is accelerated. After about 3 to 4 days, the new epidermis layer in the form of silver skin covers the fresh tattoo. The silver skin often causes severe itching because it dries out and then flakes. The partially colored, partially milky white skin scales fall off by themselves during the healing process of the tattoo. Sleeve. The term sleeve is used for tattooed arms. A distinction is made here between a full sleeve and a half sleeve, depending on whether the tattoo can still be covered by a short or a rolled-up shirt sleeve. A sleeve encloses the complete arm area. There are professions in which it is not welcome or even forbidden to show your tattoos openly. Half sleeves are particularly suitable here, as they can be easily concealed in the office if required. Stencil. The stencil is nothing more than the blueprint. With the blueprint, the tattoo artist transfers the motif template onto the skin. Sterility. Currently, there is no uniform legal regulation for hygienic standards in tattoo studios. Nevertheless, it is natural for serious tattoo studios to provide sterility. Disposable needles and disinfection sprays for cleaning the machine, the storage surfaces, and the couches have long been the norm. A conscientious tattoo artist also works exclusively with latex disposable gloves. More and more often, you can also see tattoo artists working with a mask. The measures taken to ensure sterility are also an important indication when assessing a tattoo studio. Tattoo convention. Tattoo conventions are events for tattoo artists and tattoo fans. The tattoo convention in Frankfurt on Main is one of the largest conventions worldwide. Usually, conventions take place once a year. Tattoo artists can advertise themselves and their studio to tattoo customers on site and convince the jury and visitors of their work at the often held contests. The contests are held in different disciplines and are often endowed with money. The first tattoo convention was held in America in 1976. It was organized by the North American Tattoo Club. Tattoo conventions are not only for the self-advertisement of the exhibiting tattoo artists, but also for the networking within the scene. Conventions are not only a platform to present new styles and techniques. Also, machines and ink manufacturers present their assortment and offer their products for sale. Trash polka. In any case, one of the essential elements of trash polka is the reduced color scheme in black, gray, and red. Abstract designs combined with realistic elements are another important feature of trash polka. This type of motif is often complemented by typewriter type letters. In trash polka, minimalism, coarseness, subtlety, and wildness come together. In the end, it is precisely these contrasts that create a harmonious overall picture. Trend tattoos. Trend tattoos are tattoos that are particularly often desired by customers. In the 90s, for example, tribals were particularly sought after motifs. Often, the body parts on which the tattoos are inked are the same. Among the best-known trend motifs are the Coxic Tribal, which is now known as the Tramp Stamp, as well as Chinese characters, stars, and infinity signs. Walk-in. Walk-ins are, so to speak, the contrast to appointments. Walk-in really means what the name suggests, and that is exactly the idea behind it. The customer can come to the tattoo studio without an appointment, choose a motif, and have it inked directly. Usually, a walk-in is offered as a special offer on a certain day, or, for example, on a Saturday evening. With walk-ins, the following principle applies. First come, first serve. Walk-ins usually only accept simple or small motifs that do not require further elaboration and can be realized without much preparation. From time to time, tattoo studios advertise their walk-in, also with wannadoos, which they have already designed in advance and can tattoo directly. Wannado. Wannado refers to motifs that were not created specifically for a customer. A wannado is therefore a finished ad spec template that the customer can have inked. Many tattoo artists use wannadoos, for example, for advertising purposes and social networks, and thus search for customers who like the motif. Usually, the elaboration of the motif can still be adjusted a little bit.